action. Hey everyone, Ben here.
Ashton Jordan, raised in Charleston.
Live in Leicestershire, studied
Joshua.
And now work in Coventry.
Studied in Coventry, work.
Jamie,
Melissa,
born in Coventry,
born in Poole.
Emily,
raised in
Coventry.
Hi, I'm Nick, I'm from Coventry.
Hi, my name is Laura and I'm a former student from Coventry University.
What's your name?
Alice.
And where do you live?
Coventry.
I'm Kay Ward and I'm 100 years old. In fact, I'm 101 in a fortnight. All I can think is I like people. I like to socialise and it's put a stop to that in a way. I like to be able to... I can't get very far these days because physically I'm handicapped. Mentally I'm still not too bad. But I miss talking to people and giving your friends a hug, things like that. That's what I want to come back.
So I think people have rallied together to become a lot more supportive and make more effort.
Well, I turned 30, so the big 3-0. There was going to be a nice gathering, friends and family, and to celebrate me getting old but wiser. But then obviously that was put on hold, and yeah, that was a hard day because having my parents on either side of the fence, not being able to hug me or just embrace me, that sucked.
One of my most memorable memories of lockdown was going to the allotment with my father. My father was high risk, so we couldn't connect in any way, but he needed to plant some vegetables in the garden in his allotment, and that opportunity to help him out and be outside and kind of laugh from a distance really made me feel a bit more reconnected with him.
My favourite memory of lockdown was it happened to be my grand's 80th birthday and my granddad and my granddad's 60th wedding anniversary around the same time. So we had these two big celebrations, socially distanced, within their garden. So we were either side of the garden, and even though there was that kind of space between us, it was a really joyous occasion. That those small times of little family time really helped, and I'm so glad I got to share it.
My dad was in the vulnerable category, so he was asked to shield for 12 weeks. So on Father's Day, I actually went round and sat in the back garden, and he was there, and it was nice to obviously see him. And we did a family quiz between me and my brothers, so we had people on phones and sat in the back garden and whatnot. So yeah, it was nice to have sort of a bit of a moment together when we haven't really been able to properly do that.
Memorable part of lockdown was getting to know the kind of green spaces and countryside around where I live and further afield in the West Midlands. Having the time to go out and go to the woods and see new places was just really lovely and helped with all the stresses.
So I wanted to talk about a memorable moment for me during lockdown. And we'd been in lockdown for quite a while and I was really missing human contact. And my friends on my door, socially distancing, of course, and they just dropped by for a chat. And they stood at the end of my front garden and I stood by the front door and we just talked about all sorts. But it wasn't quite the same as just being able to phone them because they were actually there. And it was just so nice to be able to have some human contact and just to talk in person outside and be able to see their faces for real and see their bodies and yeah, just then be there physically.
A memorable moment for me was actually myself and my two company managers all decided that we rushed Coventry to go and pick up our equipment, set, props, costume things that were in our storage space. And just as we finished the unload, dividing everything up, and it was time for us to go, it was that sudden moment where the three of us sort of realised this is probably going to be the last time we see each other in person for quite some time.
Yeah,
actually moved back home to Latvia to be closer to my family and friends. It was very hard for me to be quarantined and isolated from everyone, being able to see them and not being able to touch them or hug them. During this time, I talked with people all over the world. I talked with my friends, and this is something I want to take from this experience. I want to keep in touch more with people.
For me, one of the most memorable moments of the lockdown was all of the times that we've been able to gather online in a group in a way which we wouldn't have been able to otherwise, and learn different ways of communicating and building these networks, I think, which just wouldn't have happened otherwise, has probably been my favourite bit of lockdown.
I kind of got back in touch with nature, I guess. I kind of went into astronomy and astrology, and it's great where I live because I live on the top floor of a tower block, so at night time I can even see the stars really well when the sky is clear. Yeah, that kind of helped me feel a bit less isolated because I felt like, you know, we're only a small piece of the story. We're, you know, there's a massive story out there and we're just a little part of it.
So. It's depressing. Not seeing your family and friends, but on the other hand, knowing that they, you know, phoning them and knowing they're all right.
I make, knit a lot of cardigans, jumpers for the grandchildren, and my daughter plays Elm, because I wash them before I send them through the post, but when they get there and she gives them to the children, she said they won't take them off, and she's asked them why, and they said, well, they smell like grandma. And even when she wants to wash them, she's got a fight with them before she can put them in the washer. And it makes me feel, because I'm not there and being able to hold them and get near them, that they're finding their way through my knitting. You know, I don't know whether it's the scent or the washing powder or what have you that I use. You know that it's me.
I lived through the Second World War. I saw Coventry burning, and I saw it afterwards. I saw it when it was just a pile of rubble, because my mother bought me. And she said, I want you to see this, because I'll tell you something, Coventry will rise again, and it'll be greater and stronger.
It would be very strange if you could go through life without any worries or troubles. It happens to everybody sometime or other. Yes, it does. But you do have to get through it. And like you say, you do have to be brave sometimes.